What If the Shark Wears Tennis Shoes? By Winifred Morris. Stephen brushed his teeth and put on his pajamas, but he didn't crawl into bed. Instead, he sat in the middle of his bed and held his knees tight under his chin. When his mother came upstairs to kiss him goodnight, he said,
"Stay with me. I'm too scared to sleep."
"But there's nothing to be afraid of," his mother assured him. "Nothing can hurt you here in your bed." Stephen wasn't so sure. He said,
"What if a shark comes? What if he eats me?"
"That's impossible," said his mother. "Sharks live in the ocean."
"You don't know everything," Stephen told her. "What if just one shark got tired of living in the ocean? And what if he's going to come here tonight?"
"You ask too many questions. Where do you get such silly ideas? We live too far from the ocean for a shark to be able to get here." Stephen wasn't so sure. "Now, good night," said his mother.
"But," said Stephen, "what if he hitchhikes? I bet a shark would like to hitchhike. I bet a big, hungry shark would like to get a ride in a station wagon full of boys like me."
"No one would give him a ride," said his mother.
"Then what if he steals a Ferrari? I bet a shark would like to steal a Ferrari and offer rides to boys like me."
"You ask too many questions. Where do you get such silly ideas? A shark couldn't find you here in your house." Stephen wasn't so sure. "Now, good night," said his mother.
"No," said Stephen. "What if he has a compass and a map? What if he learned how to use them at camp? I bet at his camp he would also learn how to follow the tracks left by boys like me."
"We always lock our house at night."
"What if he has a key?"
asked Stephen.
"What if he always carries lots of spare keys because he uses them like files to sharpen his teeth?"
"He couldn't climb the stairs to your room," said his mother. Stephen wasn't so sure.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.